it's almost just to find his opponent. He just kind of throws it out there. He actually comes up short usually with his jabs, misses most jabs, because this is where he wants to be. This round was fought almost exclusively at long range until the last 15 seconds. Tough one to judge. We'll be back.
What is it, Professor?
I've discovered a way to get all long-distance calls for only 99 cents.
99 cents?
The light. We start the sixth round.
Wipe that water there.
Fifth round fought very differently from the first four. Lau's gone back to an orthodox stance now, and it looks like he might want to be a little bit busier in this round.
Here are the numbers, and you can see the big drop-off in the fifth round after throwing 95 punches in round four, a little more than half that in the last round, which was fought at long range, and that's a place where Rafael Ruelas does not particularly feel comfortable.
You know, I just feel more secure in close. You know? I like it in close, you know. I feel that on the outside, you can get caught at the end of a shot, you know, a swinging wild shot. In close, I feel that I have good leverage. You know, and I just feel comfortable inside.
It is a more enjoyable way to fight, too, on the inside. The rounds go by quicker. It's fun when you fight on the inside. When you get on the outside, it kind of drags off also for the fighters. I know it drags for the fans, but for the fighters, too, they want the excitement. They feel that rush and feed off the crowd.
You know, couldn't it be more grueling, though, and basically enervating and really take a lot more out of you, though?
It does, no doubt. No doubt it does. But you know what? When you're in that ring, you're in such a focus that you're ready for the challenge. You want to extend yourself. You want to make it an exciting fight. You want the fans to be into it also. Oh, good luck to from Morales inside. Hicklett Lau doing a terrific job boxing that last round.
I think Hicklett Lau, though, is starting to let Ruelas dictate how this fight is going to go.
And now Lau trying to keep Ruelas pinned on the ropes, which, of course, is where Ruelas doesn't mind being.
Get him out. Let's go.
Every hard puncher has to have someone there available to punch. They have to be accepting your punches. And that's what Rafael Ruelas loves to have his opponents do. Not to run, not to box, not to move. Like two freight trains running together as opposed to one running in the back of the other.
Your
card, Rich, a one-point edge in a very close fight right now for Ruelas.
I must admit, I thought that Ruelas would have a little easier time of it tonight than he has against a foe that has this little experience. But Hicklett Lau's gone in there to fight tonight, and he has fought.
Yeah, I think he has, too, and I still think that this could come down on the part of Ruelas to ring rust if there is any. On the other hand, Lau, as we've said, has only gone 10 rounds once, never gone 9, 8, or 7.
Don't be holding, Lau. Don't be holding. Stop pointing. Oh, my God. Watch the head coming in. Let's go.
And now again, he goes southpaw.
Hi, Lisa McMahon.
What a reminder to watch Going Deep. Chris Myers hosting the show that the critics call the 60 Minutes of Sports Television. It comes your way Sundays at 9 on Fox Sports Net. Check your local listings. We're underway in round 7, and very difficult fight, I think, for the judges to score here. You can make a case for either fighter in almost every round. Now, the last three rounds have been fought very differently from the first four.
I thought the first couple of rounds were pretty much in Ruelas's corner, but I think Lau may have had a little case of the jitters, you know, and perhaps he was a little nervous. I mean, he's never stepped in there with a guy with this kind of experience, this kind of resume as a Rafael Ruelas. But once he's gotten into the fight and warmed to the fight, Barry, he's been more than just competitive.
I think he has, yeah. In fact, I think there was a time he was dictating the fight. I'm not sure that's the case right now. But again, I think attrition is going to really be the telling story in this fight.
Well, Lau has been active, of course. Ruelas has not. On the other hand, Ruelas has been long distance a lot of times. And as you pointed out, I mean, Lau's only been more than six rounds once.
Well, it's interesting when you look at the ring records of these two that while that's a very valid point, the last time that Rafael Reyes went as many as 10 rounds was back in 1996.
To imagine the guy that's been this tall for this division, you know, lightweight and super, would, and with his reach, would not use the jab more than he does to any effect at all. But this is his style of fighting.
Lau hasn't really been able to crank much power in the last couple of rounds. Fatigue is setting in, is not yet apparent.
There have been many, you know, who truthfully have questioned the wisdom of the comebacks of the Reyes brothers, but I think part of that is based on the fact that they're such likable people, both Gabriel and Rafael. They're among the most likable people probably in boxing in the 90s.
Absolutely.
And people are concerned for it.
Yeah, you don't want to see a fighter take a beating, especially, as you said, somebody as likable as the Reyes brothers. And, of course, with the style of there's much more chance of that. I mean, the margin between very good and not so very good is much more narrow.
Doesn't your body love fruit?
Everybody loves fruit.
Hanging fruit?
We come to round number eight now in a fight that could still be in the balance here.
But Lau comes out with a new strategy this round. Bouncing around, lateral movement, popping the jab out, and popping it out strong.
The average punches per round, and as you can see, there's been a rather dramatic drop-off, at least on the part of Rafael Reyes. I think one of the reasons for that, of course, is that Lau has not allowed Reyes inside, where he's been able to throw a whole lot of punches. Right now, let's go to the corner of Rafael Reyes with Sean O'Grady. Sean?
And I'm in Rafael Reyes' corner with Chato Robles. Does he seem tired in this fight, Chato?
Well, it's been a while since his last fight, because as we know, it's already been a year. What I told him to do in the first couple of rounds, I told him to go ahead, relax, and take his time. He's trying to look for a knockout. The knockout's going to come in on its own. So I want him to stay relaxed, stay focused, and just do the best he can, you know. So far, defensively-wise, he's doing a good job. He's keeping his hands up. He's moving his body side to side, bopping and weeping, which is good.
Yeah, you got him going. All right, Chato. I think he got the right idea. Barry, they think he's over here looking for the knockout. They want him to relax, and sometimes you find it.
Well, we'll see what happens right now. Lau, I think the strategy that he has adopted in this round, at least thus far, which has been rather effective.
I think it caught Reyes a little bit by surprise. Reyes really hasn't gotten started in this round yet.
And again, you must consider the fatigue factor, even though in the corner of Reyes, they didn't think he was too tired. It was a quick left hand by Lau. One thing about fighting to fight at long range, if a punch does get there, the judges will see it.
And remember, now that one really got to him. I was going to talk about his poor balance, which I thought contributed to that stagger previously, but that second left hook definitely got to him and dinged him a little.
Yeah, he was looking in some trouble.